membership requirement for East Clwyd in South Lanarkshire, and I have consulted with around 720 section people through school assemblies, youth clubs, youth surgeries and online surveys. A rights issue that was raised a lot during my rights review consultation was from mostly young people who identify as female, including high school girls, about the access to and stigma around menstrual hygiene products. This is a real issue for many young people. I spoke to, they told me they don't even know where to access them from. Period poverty is a violation of human rights, such as the rights to health, education, play and non-discrimination, which can particularly affect young people who menstruate. While some felt that they knew where and when to access them, a majority didn't. Most of them felt that even if they did know, they'd be too embarrassed to ask. The best examples were from local schools who have started to provide these sanitary products for free in the toilets. However, many constituents reported that some schools do not provide any sanitary products at all. Therefore, I welcome the Scottish Government's action in its draft plan, paragraph 6.19, to establish a scheme to fund access to free sanitary products in schools, colleges, etc. However, I further call on the Scottish Government to ensure the rights of young people who menstruate are properly protected by binding, not guiding legislation, by planning to support Monica Lennon MSP's upcoming private bill and campaign to end period poverty. This can ensure that schools, colleges and universities are duty bound to provide universal access to these essential products so that we can continue our education without any interruptions. To sum up, in 2018, it is disgusting and inhumane that girls are still having to use toilet paper instead of menstrual hygiene products. This legislation would mean Scotland be a world leader in giving all citizens the right to access its sanitary products. This issue should not be ignored. It is unhealthy and unsafe. Thank you.